Hi everybody, my name is Kevin Hurley. Welcome to the course. This is one of the series of PESTED inspection courses. We're going to do a home inspection today for occasional pests, anything that might come into a person's house, ants, roaches, spiders, that sort of thing. Let's get right into it. The first thing we have to have is safety equipment. You want to take care of yourself. You can't be injured. You won't be able to do your job. You also don't want to get hurt on the customer's property. We could have problems there. So one of the first things I like to remind people is that you need safety glasses. These are tinted safety glasses. They're great for outdoor inspections, but once you get in the house, you're going to have to take them off. So I suggest you not wear these. I suggest you wear a clear safety glass. I'm not going to wear them right now. We'll put them right here in our safety pocket. Now I have... How about right here in the middle? This is a probing tool. So this is a pretty big one. The bigger one you use, the better, because you don't have to reach far to get into areas. However, for our typical home inspection, this is really more than you need, unless you're looking for termites. This is a great tool if you're looking for termites, even longer, because some people have 9-foot ceilings and you can't get up to the sill plate. But we're not doing a termite inspection today, so we don't need this. This is a nice little one. You can carry it around. Some people use a utility belt, but you don't need a lot of tools to do a home inspection. So I just put it in my pocket, but that's totally up to you. It's probably safer to have a utility belt. Then we have the most indispensable tool for any pest control operator. This is a flashlight. Always keep your flashlights charged. A lot of these companies have chargers. You leave them in your car, so you never have to worry about that. I like this particular one. It's called a Streamlight Ultra Stinger. It's got high intensity light, and the charge lasts for 3 or 4 hours of constant use until the battery gets older and you have to replace it. Don't carry your flashlight around, guys and ladies. Make sure you get one of these handy little holders so that you don't have to drop it or place it somewhere. If you break this light, I think the last time I looked, they're about $125. And then when you buy the case and a spare battery and a charger for the car and a charger for the home, you know, you're getting up to the $200 range. So this is an expensive and valuable tool. You want to keep it in the holster. A couple things to remember when we're doing a home inspection is that this is someone's, oh, you know what? The shoes. Always have good, sturdy shoes. You're going to be walking in and out of crawl spaces, basements. You don't want sneakers. Something could drop on your foot. So make sure that your shoes are solid. You don't want your feet to be sore at the end of the day. And long pants. I know it's hot where a lot of you are, you know, out in the Southwest. Here in New York, it's August. It's about 80 degrees today. So it'd be nice to be in shorts. But you don't want to damage your skin. Get bumps, cuts, and bruises. You're gonna see that customers put out a lot of landmines. There's all kinds of problems in these houses, so you have to be aware at all times. Remember, when you're going in this house, you're a hunter. You're looking for an animal. You're looking for tracks, evidence, scat, droppings, hair, dead animals, damaged food, damaged wood. So you're hunting at all times, so you wanna be prepared to go in there and get your enemy. And shorts is probably not a good idea. Another thing that you should always remember is that you're going into someone's home. This is where they live. They have children, they have their food, all their personal items are there. So be very respectful. Remember this, homes now have hidden cameras. They have alarm cameras, video, a camera to watch the baby, a camera to watch the dog, cameras for everything. So don't assume if you're probing into someone's personal space, now they're not collecting that information on film. So be very cautious and very respectful when you go into the home. Okay, so here we are at a typical home. You can hear the cars going by. One of the things I like to do is do the inside of the house first, because that way, if your feet are fairly clean from walking around inside, then you do the outside last. You don't want to do the outside first, especially on a rainy day, or if the house is under construction, you're going to bring all that mud into someone's house. It's going to upset them. So we want to keep the customer happy, and we want to be respectful of the customer's property. So let's take a look at what we have here. The first thing we're going to do, though, is a little walk around today. We're going to do a walk around. We're not going to go inside first. I want to show you what the house is about in general. So if you would, camera guy, take a look at the house here, and I'll just continue to tell you what I see. Shoot up here to the roof line a little bit. You can see this is an old elm tree, and this elm tree is hanging over the roof. Bad news. Okay, this is not what you want in a house. Carpenter ants are going to use that as an entryway right into your roof line and destroy your property. We do have above ground wires. A lot of times that can't be helped. Many of the new homes now put the wires underground, which is great, because carpenter ants can travel along these wires and get into your house. We have a vinyl siding home. It appears to be a cape with a raised left side and a deck. And so all of these areas are areas where you're going to find pests, even under that deck. So let's walk around over here a little bit, if you'll just follow me. We're going to stick to the structure primarily. I'm not really concerned what's going around on the outside, the ornamental side of this property, because today's not an ornamental class. Today's structural. We can see this person's got some construction going on. They just put in a bluestone walkway. We have new grass here. That green stuff, not the grass, the other stuff is it's a biodegradable material people put over grass seeds so it doesn't wash away. So we're going to be careful not to walk on their grass. And we'll walk in here. We have an accessible area under here we can go into. I'm not going in there. I don't have a crawl suit today. It may not be pertinent or high priority for this particular inspection, but you're going to find spiders and things like that under there. One of the areas I like to look at is on the deck, where the deck meets the wall. And we'll come back when we come around to the deck. We'll take a look. I can see some cobwebs up there. We'll look in the cobwebs to see if we have any carpenter ants in there. So keep coming. This is a second deck. There's a wire going up. You don't see that on every house. That is that's to heat the snow off the roof. So stay away from that. You don't need to touch it. Again, we're going to come out here, not stepping on the customer's new grass. We'll take a look at the roof. Would you pan up there, please? So the roof is in good shape. It's not rotted, or there don't appear to be any missed shingles. So that's a good sign. I can see a couple of bees flying around up there, or wasps right now. Maybe you can't see them yet. So we may have a nest up high on one of those dormers. Let's come around here. This is a good angle to get in. We have a hollow block foundation, and there's a lot of stuff under here. Now, somebody might go, oh, well, that's from carpenter ants, but probably not. This guy's probably mowing his lawn, and it's shooting that stuff up there. Now, there may be some cobwebs, but as I feel this, it doesn't feel like cobwebs. It just feels like regular old grass stuck up in there. Although over here we have one. Here's a little cobweb. These are the kind of areas you want to take a look. You can see if ants or moths, a lot of bugs like to build their nest in here. So there's no insects in this. I think it's just leaf litter that was blown in throughout the years. Who knows? This could have been there for 10 years. We don't know. As we move over here, we have another deck. So this house is loaded with decks. We're here in the Northeast. The Northwest also has the same issue. They have a lot of carpenter ants. So these are the kind of things carpenter ants like. They especially like to get in areas right where the deck meets the structure of the house. Moisture builds up there, and they can dig in and make their home. Okay, we're just, again, at this point of the inspection, we're just kind of getting a feel for what the house is. We're not fine-tuning anything at this point. We just want to see, what are we dealing with? So we got this deck. We got a mudroom down here, some propane tanks. Oh yeah, that reminds me, don't smoke while you're doing an inspection. Not because of the propane, but a lot of customers don't like that, so you don't want to do that. or even on their property at all, even in your truck when it's on their property. So remember, we have to be respectful of them. This is an automatic exterior generator. Don't have to touch it. We've got some ornamental shrubs protecting it. Here's another section of the house. Now let's take a look at the two color sidings. Just to give you an idea, see the siding on the left is a lot older on the main structure. So this is a newer structure. And if you look down at the foundation, you can see it's not hollow block. It's poured concrete. So this is not part of the original building. And it's probably built a little tighter. And we know the elements in here are going to be a lot newer. The electricity, the insulation, that sort of thing. As we move around here, I just want to point out the homeowner drilled some holes in here. That's not standard. I think they were having moisture problems, so they wanted to get a little airflow. Let's take a look. You can see why. Here, down here on the floor, this is the north side of the house, so we're getting a lot of mold. Again, this kind of thing can be treated or power washed away. Oh, look, the guy's got some gloves. Maybe we could use gloves. Not today. Okay. This is an area of high moisture. The air conditioner unit's there, the hose is there, and it's hard for the guy or lady, whoever owns this property, to get in there and mow, so they usually only weed whack probably, so that's going to grow up. A lot more coverage for chipmunks and ants and all kinds of different pests. Let's go right along this way. This is an extension, a sunroof built out. These are generally off the ground. This one is as well. And where the seam meets the house, that's the kind of place where you're going to have moisture and a potential buildup. Now, if we pan back, can we come back this way, cameraman? Let's get a shot on that roof. That roof has gutter covers, metal gutter covers. So you're not going to have an issue with a lot of gunk building up in the gutters and pests staying there. That's always a good thing. And cut. Okay, take a look at all this ground growth, this plant ground growth and ferns. It's right next to the foundation. It's an aesthetic thing. Some people like it. But it's a great place for mice. It's a great place for ants. It's a great place for all of our occasional invaders. Now, you're not going to get the customer to get rid of this in most cases unless they're highly phobic to insects. So you're just going to have to deal with this. One of the nice ways to treat this is a granular insecticide because it drops through the leaves and gets down underneath the leaf litter. One of the things insects love is corners. They can hide in them. So my eye automatically goes to corners. We want to check on those areas of the house. A nice big flat area, not so interesting to an insect, but a corner where they can hide. You can see some cobwebs in here. Down in here as well. And we have a lot of leaf litter. Stuff collects in the corners. So that's where the ants are going to be. That's where other pests are going to be that eat ants, like spiders or other ants. We'll move along. This is just ventilation for the kitchen. Get a close-up of that. It appears that a bird likes to come here and do his business. Now we're over to that corner. Again, take a shot up at that. That's a bad thing. This house, they should trim this tree away from the property. It looks like it's kind of old. It may even break and damage the property. So we'll come in here. Again, more areas, spider webs. My hand's pulling on spider webs right now. There's a spider web right there. The spider was in it. He's gone. A lot of little spider webs around here. So what I'm really looking for, here you can see some up here. There's a, looks like might have been a crane fly, some type of fly. It's fully deteriorated. And more spiders up here. So now me personally, I like spiders. See, that one's live in there. Oh, he just came down. He's over here now on my finger. Spiders kill other insects. So me personally, I don't really worry about spiders. On the outside of the house, a broom will take care of them. But your typical homeowner maybe doesn't want them, so that's a good thing. We found spiders. We can justify a service contract for these people. Now this house so far doesn't have a lot of pests. Always watch your step. Booby traps. Booby traps. Customers love to put out booby traps. I'll show you a whole bunch of them once we get inside. So let's walk around. They have a little flower area here. So lots of insects are going to be here, including carpenter ants, which these flowers have already past their prime, but ants love to go into the flower and get the nectar out or hunt for other insects on the flowers. So you want to look around this area, see if you can find any carpenter ants or other pests. Now we're going to go down into the basement. Okay, I'm in a mudroom going down into the basement now. Show your lens right down here. You can see that there is an algae or mold type of growth here, and this is an indication that we have a moisture area. Now, it's a retaining wall, so of course it's going to be moist, and it doesn't get any sunlight because it's blocked. That doesn't mean there's something structurally wrong with the property, but it's something to be concerned about or aware of at the very least. Now I'm in the mudroom. We've got a sump pump and a drain. So again, this may just be here for the water. Get a shot at those steps. See, those concrete steps, the water may just come down here and go into the drain and be pumped out by the sump. It may not indicate that there's a problem elsewhere in the house, but again, this is what we're supposed to be looking for. We have to be aware of moisture. Remember, insects love heat, insects love moisture. If you take a look at the sill plate, this is the sill plate. This is hollow block, so we're still in the old part of the house. They have a live catch trap up here. This is called a repeater trap or live catch low profile tin cat. See that in the past? Those are mousy skins. Ugh. So they definitely have mice here. And we've got a nice spider over here with her eggs. Ah! All right, I wasn't really scared at all. I wasn't scared, all right? I just do that because I want people to, you know, think I'm human. Anyway, here are the eggs. So there's a broom. How do you get rid of spiders? Goodbye. That's not gonna keep them away forever. That spider's probably gonna hunt me down tonight for what I just did. Oh well. You're gonna need a pesticide application if you want long-term control of spiders. But that's the first thing you should do. We're not really here to show a treatment today. I should be more sticking to an inspection, but if something comes up, I'm gonna run it by you. We have snap traps. There's an old dusty snap trap. Probably hasn't caught a mouse in a long time. This one doesn't have dust on it, but what does it have on it? It has hair, dried blood. Ew. Yeah. So this thing has done its job. You never buy these and throw them away. Keep using them over and over. Mice are not really smart. Mice don't care if there's dead mice all over the trap. They're still going to come right in and jump on it like a trampoline or whatever they do. And so this person is keeping their sill plate free of mice, and this is at ground level on the outside, so this is where the mice come in, and they're going to catch them before they get into the house. It's a good idea. Now let's break in the threshold here. One of the things, you always want to have the lights on first. Don't go into somebody's basement or dark area and then, oh, where are the lights? Know where the lights are first. We ask the homeowner to turn these lights on ahead of time. So we've got a lot of booby traps here. We got a lot of things that are going to cause problems for you and get you hurt. So let's go over some of those. Now here's a crawl space. Take a look. This is poured concrete foundation with insulation. You're not going to pull all that insulation down and look at every single thing, but you are going to look around in the corners for carpenter ants and other pests. Let's check right here on the edge. Now, someone has come in here recently, so there's no cobwebs. So they use this every once in a while.
We have more spiders up here. So this customer has laid out a gauntlet for us. They've got skis and very sharp snowshoes. Can you get a shot of those snowshoe blades? Yeah, so this kind of thing, you know, you got to be careful with. And how would you get in there anyway? So let's back up. Now, unless you brought a ladder with you, which you should do if you're going to do a good inspection, you're not going to be able to get in there without hurting yourself or breaking this pipe. So I'm going to borrow the homeowner's little step stool. Don't borrow the homeowner's step stool. First of all, I'm going to do it, but don't you do it. Because you don't know if they took care of this thing. I could step on this and it could break right now and that would be the end of the movie. But I happen to know this one holds me. So I'm going to crawl in there and we'll come back in a second. Okay, this is the crawl space. Let's see if I can zoom this thing. There's the crawl space, new section of the house. Not getting too good on the autofocus there, so we're going to back out a little. And let's just take a look around here. As we got all kinds of hazards, insulation. You want to check the windows. That's where you're going to find insects. Something I noticed over here, and let's see if we can play with the zoom a little. So we don't have any insects or dead mice or anything in this area, but we have something else. Booby traps. Glass. So somebody decided to leave glass in here. I don't know what kind of glass it is, but I know it's the kind that cuts you. So these are why you wear coveralls and gloves when you're going into these crawl spaces. Got a little moth there, but no mounds of dead ants, not a lot of problems in this crawl space. So I did use the customer's small ladder, step ladder, and you always remember, if you do happen to use somebody's stuff, which I would suggest you do, always put it back exactly where it was. Because if I put it over there, and a customer comes down and trips over it and breaks their leg, guess who they're going to blame? So you definitely want to first not use their stuff, but if you do, put it back exactly where it was. Where they trip over it, and they're going to say, well, that wasn't where it was, and then they're going to blame you. So respect them, take care of them. We have some little booby traps here. We'll close them, get them out of our way. We have to remember to open that back up later. Now, if you'll pan up to the sill plate, so this makes it very difficult to do an inspection. It's a great idea for the homeowner. The homeowner has insulation in each of the between each of these floor joists. If this was a termite inspection and you want it to be really thorough, you'd start pulling those off and look for those termites because that's where they're going to be. But we're not doing wood destroying organisms today. We're just going to do a home inspection and look for conducive conditions to pests. You can see here at some point there was a leak and it is a bathtub up there. So at some point they had a leak. This wood is very dry right now, so it must have just been years ago and they repaired whatever it was. These are your pipes coming down from gray water and sewage. Dryer is a place where you might find carpet beetles, other types of dermestids. Carpet beetles live on stuff like this. Ah, this one's clean. But the lint that's in here, the carpet, now they won't live in here because it's too annoying for them, but you can't eliminate lint. A lot of times people will have their dryer upstairs in a living area and there's going to be lint on the floor and that's, carpet beetles are going to love that. We'll come in here. Time to break out the flashlight. We have a little light here. Every light you turn on, turn off when you leave. So we have some moisture in here. This is hollow block, so we know we're still in the old part of the building. This is a bacteria light, a sediment filter, holding tank for water, a reverse osmosis system. I'm just gonna look up here. Again, loaded pretty good with spiders. Just take a look around the sill. Now, while I'm here, I might wanna just give these sills a little tap for carpenter ants. See if anything's been eating them. You can hear the sound. Hear this sound? Very solid, no moisture in there at all. In good shape. Let's go back over to this other corner and hit it again. Again, very solid, no problems here structurally. Stay away from this stuff, okay? Unless you're an electrician. These circuit breaker panels can cause a lot of trouble for you. Now I'm just gonna go up in here and look for more damage along the sill plate. Check lower corners. Now there's a lot of hazards here, you know, that the customer left, but it's fairly, you know, not quite broom clean, but there's not a lot of dead animals or insects around. Here's something. What do we got? A click beetle. So it's a kind of a destroyed old click beetle. So at this point, we can easily justify a pest control treatment. We found pests. That's up to you and the customer whether they actually do it. So we have another light switch over here. I'm going to turn this on. And again, more spiders. Now, someone might say, well, you just have spiders. Well, what do spiders eat? They don't eat salami sandwiches. Pizza, mostly. But when they're not eating pizza, they eat other insects. So if we've got spiders in every single corner of the house so far and on the outside of the house, even though we can't see a lot of other pests, they're here. And they're probably behind the wall, so they're out foraging around on the lawn today. I'll show you real quick. So this stuff comes out fairly easy. If it's old, it'll rip in your hands. So don't rip it out. But this stuff comes out fairly easy if it's in good shape. Some people might want to call that carpenter frass, ant frass. It's not. It's just a bunch of old sawdust and gunk from years ago that built up in here. Spider webs, cobwebs. I don't know what a cob is, but maybe it's cobwebs. I think a cobweb and a spider web are pretty similar. Still looking, no leaks, keeping my head down, looking for dead insects. Here we go. What do we got? I think that's what they call a harvester. Some people call them daddy long legs. They're different things, actually. So they hunt other insects, so we know we got some other insects here. Oh, look, another booby trap. Keep your eyes open. Pan the area all the time. Great place for insects. So this spider caught himself a moth and a little baby crane fly, and there he is. He's so happy. I'm messing with his buffet. It's summer. You're gonna have spiders. Lots of them, though. My God. All spiders are venomous, but most of them can't bite us because their palps, where they inject the venom, is too small. So your bigger spiders, like your wolf spiders, brown recluse, black widows, they can penetrate your skin. But a lot of these little household spiders, even though they have venom to kill their prey, they can't pierce our skin, so we're in good shape. That's why I don't usually get too afraid touching a spider web. Now clowns freak me out, but spider webs, no. Okay, so we're almost done here. Oil tank, behind the oil tank, underneath, then we have some drippage here that's probably just from condensation off the wall. That white stuff is a sealant for the wall. And be careful of this when you're walking in here. This is the oil pipe, now oil line. It's orange, so you should stay away from it. This customer actually put a PVC pipe over this part so you wouldn't step on it and break it. This tells me at one point we probably had a pet in the family. I don't know if they still do or not. But this was a dog food container. So that's going to draw in all kinds of pests. Meal moths, for one. Spider beetles. Any kind of stored product pest. This area, so we've been able to inspect. This is pretty open. We've been able to inspect most of this downstairs. This area I can't get into. This is a booby trap area. I'm not going to move people's stuff around. I definitely don't want to because I don't want to break it. If I have to do a written home inspection report, I'll say, oh, look at a chipmunk. You got him? Do you see him? Where'd he go? There he is. Okay, so I think these people need a wildlife trapper. Did he go? Okay. All right, John, you can pay the chipmunk now. Yeah, just pay him cash. We're not going to need him again.
Now we're going to go into the inside of the home. There's a few things you want to remember before you go inside. One of them is, it's not your home. It's somebody else's. They've got private stuff in there. They have things maybe they don't even want you to know about. So anything that you see when you're in there that has nothing to do with this inspection, forget it, okay? It's like Vegas. Leave it there. Remember, there's going to be a lot of booby traps in here. Now, in different parts of the country, people charge different amounts for pest control jobs. If it's a one-time, they might charge $200. If it's an annual program, it could be as much as $900, $1,000, depending on the size of the house. If I go into this property and I knock over Grandma's Ming Dynasty lamp that's worth $500,000, it really doesn't pay to do a $500 pest control job. So we got to be very careful, and we're going to go in now.
Watch out for booby traps, kids' toys, people who leave their sandals around on the floor. This is a typical home. You know, sometimes you're going to go into a house and they have a housekeeper, a maid, live-in housekeepers, and those houses are going to be, everything's going to be put away. But a lot of times, middle America, the average person doesn't have that sort of thing. So they're just going to leave the house. Maybe they're at work. They're not going to necessarily do a lot for you. So that makes your job more difficult. And you just have to be aware of it. So we're going to check the kitchens and bathrooms now. Somebody had breakfast here recently. So some of the obvious places are going to be where food is left out. I'm going to use my flashlight, take a quick look around. They're leaving peaches out. You might have some fruit flies, though this peach seems to be in good shape. Here's some styrofoam peanuts. They're not really food. One of the things you want to do is look up. Look up in the corners. Again, a little cobweb up there, a little spider web. Let's go over here. A little cobweb. Don't see any live spiders, but a little cobweb. This corner. Cobwebs and a live spider. So these people called the right person, because we can take care of this for them. This kind of area, the dishwasher, has a lot of moisture, and there's always a space in between the dishwasher and the cabinets. This is prime for carpenter ants, so you want to look down here, see if you find frass or any dead carpenter ants. Never make a comment to your customer about their home unless it's a positive one, like, gee, this is a really a clean home. But don't lie, because they'll know. Stoves are another area. There's an area in here and behind the stoves where you're going to get a lot of ants. Again, I don't see a single ant in this house. They've got honey out here on the counter, but that's where no one ever cleans back there. So you can look back there. It's not a bad place to put a mouse trap or mouse bait. This is a pantry area. We have a light here. Again, look up. Pantries. Indian meal moth's going to be at the top. They love to crawl to the ceiling to pupate. Nothing. So we don't really have it. We have some old dead insects in there. Could have been there for 20 years. Who knows? These people have some kind of homebrew going on. Lots of clutter. Papers. Recyclables. You know, I'm not going to tear through these recyclables, but I might take a cursory look and go, all right, well, they're cleaning the recyclables at least, so they're probably not going to have cockroaches in there or some other kind of pest. Do a quick look around the floor for mouse droppings. You know, it's you pull out some things. You want to take a look. Pull out a few things, look around. There's a mosquito flying around back there. But again, you don't want to
You don't want to rip the house apart. It's not your job, and you don't want to find things that you don't want to find also. Coming into a living room area or a dining room area, same things apply. Again, we got another spider up here, more cobwebs. Spider over there, more cobwebs. So the house, number one priority, or pest in this house, as you can see, is spiders. But as I said in the past, if you got spiders, you got other things too, because spiders need something to eat. This home's out in the country, it's hard to get pizza delivered, so they're gonna eat other insects. Don't forget your closets. Closets are places animals love insects. Animals, and because people don't go in them a lot, so some dog hair. You want to look in here? There's some old sneakers. They're not my size, so I'm gonna leave them. And way in the corner, you can't get to it. It's just more dust, really. No insects, so it's a good thing. I'm gonna look up here for insects, and we got none. Ceilings, floors, corners. That's where they're gonna be. We're gonna come into the bathroom here and take a look at, we've got typical homeowner stuff, but what you're concerned about here is you wanna get in here. And if this is totally full of stuff, I don't know if you can get in there, cameraman. This is fairly empty. We don't have any water drainage, no problems there. You can move this stuff around if you want to take a look, but I can tell right away that no insects are hanging out in this area. Though it is a common area for insects, this is not bad at all, just a little dusty. So we've had a lot of rain and a lot of heat, and that helps spiders. Spiders love it because the other insects are hatching and they get to eat it, and they're insects. Well, they're not insects, but they're arachnid pest, and they love heat and humidity as well, at least the ones we have here in the Northeast. As you can see, we got even more spiders and some, oh, there's a live one, little house spiders, some food in their nest, and we'll go up the stairs. Keep in mind, we're in someone's home, so we don't know, are they videotaping us? I mean, I know this guy's videotaping me, but do they have cameras around? We don't know. So you don't want to, you know, it's nice if you want to do a home inspection. It's really not important to go looking through people's drawers, so I would suggest you not do it unless it's a bed bug inspection, because bed bugs do hang out in drawers. But I would look everywhere else first. And now this house is a cape. You can see this dormer here coming out. So from the outside, these would be the what they call the eyes, you know, looking out at you. So there's always a crawl space up here in the attic area or the second floor area, and it overhangs the house. So we're gonna move this aside and take a look in here. This one is nice enough to have a light in it, which is good. And I'll take the camera here if you don't mind. Thank you. So in here, it's hot, it's dry. This would be a good place for carpenter ants to build a nest in up in this area. So they'll build the nest up in the rafters. And you'll see the frass down here if we have them. But I don't see any frass. But I do see mouse traps. So this customer knows they have mice. It's been a while since these have caught anything. They don't have any. They actually have cobwebs on them. So it's been a long time since any mouse has been in one of those. And over here, I'm just looking around trying to find dead ants, that kind of thing, but I don't see any. So I do see some little seeds over here, and that means we had mice up in here at one time eating. This is insulation. You can check this insulation. Just make sure it doesn't have any water stains on it. That would be an indication that they have water damming in the winter, or there's other kinds of leaks, and that's the first place the carpenter ant will build their nest. Okay, so we finished our inspection of this property for conducive conditions to household pests. We pretty much checked out everything that can be checked out without going into excruciating detail or ripping things apart. The last thing you want to do after you say goodbye to your customer and prepare any report you want to give to them is make sure you didn't leave anything behind. So I've got my screwdriver and I've got my I don't have my flashlight. So that flashlight is somewhere in that house, probably on a dryer in the basement somewhere. It's $125, so I gotta go back in and get it. But I'm not gonna put you through that. So thank you for watching this pested.com video, and we'll see you next time.